All right. Good morning.
Good morning.
So our Think Green Thursday class today is on planting trees and shrubs. So I thought the best thing to do was actually come outside and plant a shrub. So we've got a frost-proof gardenia that we're going to plant. We don't have a gardenia in the garden now, do we, Chris? Nope. So a new addition to the garden. So the first thing you want to do is determine the size of the hole that you're going to dig. And I dug this yesterday because I wasn't sure how hard it was going to be, and it was pretty hard. So the width of this pot is about 13 inches. So we're trying to get a hole that is 2 to 3 times as wide as what the pot is. We want to have plenty of room for the roots to get established. So we want some loose soil in there to work with there. So I've got the hole about 38 inches wide, so almost 3 times as wide as a pot. The next thing we need to do too is make sure that they have the right depth. That's one of the biggest problems people have, is they'll plant their shrubbery too deep. So we want to make sure we don't get this too deep. Matter of fact, I like to have them probably an inch above grade. It's better to have them high than low any day of the week. So the total height of our pot is about 11 inches, and then the soil level inside the pot is probably 2 inches, 2.5 inches less. So we've got about 9 or 9.5 inches of actual height of root ball there. So I'm hoping that when I did my digging, and I used my rake just to measure, I'm trying to get a height of about 9 inches or so on top of the rake handle. So that should put my root ball about an inch above, and I'm pretty close to about 9 inches there. In any case, I'd rather be a little bit higher than low in any case. The bottom of the hole should be fairly solid. I dug this probably about an inch too deep, but I put some fill back in and I packed it down pretty well. So it should be okay to not have this settle out on us. I prepared the soil. So this soil came out of the hole. I mixed in a fair amount of pine bark fines. The pot and soil is 100% pine bark, and we're going into about 100% clay. I like to have a transition zone. So this is about 50-50 native soil with the pine bark, just to ease the roots out into the soil. The gardenia, yes. Yes, right, so you can, right. So this is a finely ground up pine bark. Anything that you buy in a bag that says topsoil or soil conditioner will be pine bark. So it's not really soil. And then you can buy this in bulk at some places around that sell mulch around town. But anything in a bag that says topsoil or soil conditioner is always pine bark. So you can buy it in a bag that way. Maybe the shrubbery, right. Okay. Other thing to consider is we do need a little fertilizer. Our soils are naturally low in phosphorus, so we want to have a little phosphorus in there. The gardenia prefers acidic soil, so we won't add any lime to the soil, but we'll add some fertilizer. So what I'm going to do is put in about a half a cup, and this is a 8-10-8 fertilizer. Put about a half a cup in here, and I'm going to mix that in. And so that'll be in our backfill. So as the roots are growing over the winter time, it's going to have a little bit of fertilizer in there to help it grow. We especially want that phosphorus in there for root growth. All right. Now, then once we get the pot off of the plant, and normally the best way to do this is just lay it down and then just kind of slide, hopefully, slide the plant out of the pot. Okay, so that looks pretty good. We do have some excess roots on the side there, and we really need to break these roots up. If we don't, then we're going to have circling roots and the shrub just won't get established very well. The way I like to do it is take my old kitchen knife and I'll just cut these roots off. So I'll just slice down the side. And at that point in time then, we won't have any circling roots because all those are gone. Doesn't hurt the plant at all. Go ahead and slice those off. And that avoids the possibility of having circling roots on the plant. They may girdle it later on. It's not really bad root bound, but this will help. Chris watered these yesterday. We want to make sure the root ball was very moist before we put it in the ground. This pine bark soil is very hard to wet once it's in the ground. Yeah, all right. So I feel pretty good about that. So we should not have a problem with this as far as girdling roots. Now we'll see what my depth looks like. And I was gonna try and handle the plant real carefully, as much by the root ball as possible, not so much by the top, because you can damage the plant if you do that. And that looks pretty good. I think height-wise, we're in pretty good shape. Chris, what's the front of our plant? Do I need to rotate it?
Is that flower
still on it? Yes, it is. Flower in the front. Is that good? Is that right?
Yeah, there you go.
Okay.
It's a pretty symmetrical plant.
Yeah. So I mean, ideally some plants will have a front side, so I always kind of turn it and see. Does it look pretty straight? Yes. That looked pretty straight. Up and back and forth. We're kind of in the middle of the hole, so what I'll do now then is start the backfilling process. And this is a mixture about 50-50, the native soil and the pine bark, so that we've got a transition area. Right. And you can see that this is what, that's what came out of the hole. So I really don't want to put these big old chunks of clay right back in the hole. I'd rather have it chopped up some and have some of this pine bark fines in there with it. Then once I get it about halfway filled, then I'll come back and just pack it a little bit. Sometimes you'll see some recommendations where they'll say, fill it halfway and water it. It does help settle the soil, but it makes it a mess. And I just soon pack it with my foot and I can come back once I'm completely finished and then fill it in. Now's the time of year, perfect. It's starting to cool off a little bit, hopefully. At some point in time, we'll have some rain. Then the shrubs have a chance to grow roots and get established over the winter time. Thank you. That makes it a little bit neater, easier to clean up. But I'm still gonna have some clods to deal with after the fact. All right. Then I wanna get out on the ground and make sure I can see the root ball, make sure the soil is up even with the top of the root ball, and that's it. So sometimes people put soil on top of the root ball, and that's bad too. The soil won't allow the plant to breathe, and you can kill it that way. So soil comes to the edge of the root ball, and then we can come back and mulch around the plant. But we won't put mulch on top of the root ball, but we still want to make sure that the plant can breathe when it's all said and done. Think about that. And that's pretty good. Okay. Our next plant is going to be this Deodar cedar. It's a very unique looking plant. What happens with some plants, depending on where you take a cutting, the cutting that comes off a side branch may continue to grow the way it was growing. Instead of being upright, like it should, it grows sideways. So we're gonna put that on the fence and train it kind of a espalier, like on the fence. The cedar does not like acidic soil, so we will add some lime to the soil. Well, so native cedars are not cedars, they're junipers. And they would tolerate acidic soils, but this is a real cedar and it doesn't like it so much. So I got a half a cup of fertilizer and I put a cup of lime on the soil. Give that a little mix. And again, I put pine bark fines in there with the native soil to break up all the big clay clods. Now this is a little bit trickier because our hole is on a slope. So a little bit harder to determine the actual depth of the hole since the hole itself is on a sloping land. So we may have to kind of fiddle with this a little bit. Again, we're gonna lay the pot down, trying to slide it out kind of gently. The roots on this one look pretty good. So we don't really have circling roots, anything bad on this. We can just rough them up a little bit, and I think that's sufficient with this plant. Doesn't nearly have as many roots as the gardenia did. All right, now let's see how this is gonna work. I want to try and get this in, and we want this as close to the fence as we can get it. Is that about right, Chris? Think that's okay? And then we're going to tie the branches to the fence as it grows. So that's okay. We're a little bit high on the backside, but I'm not gonna worry about that too much. We're pretty close to the right height in the front. All right. I might have to pack this by hand because I can't get my foot on the backside. We just want to firm that soil best we can so it doesn't settle too much. Sweep the walk. I think it's going to stay about where it is. It's going to grow long, but I don't think it's going to grow up at all. I think it's just going to grow right along the fence. It's what we think. Don't really know. It'll be an experiment. So we're pretty good right there. The top of the root ball is exposed. We got soil up to the edge of the root ball. Then I can come back and rake this out and put some mulch around it. I may put a little mulch on top, but probably not much. And then we'll tie this up against the fence and we'll see what happens. All right, so we got one more. Yeah, this is really pretty. Okay. So our depth of our hole is about right. I think we're good on that. I'm gonna go ahead and get some fertilizer in the soil. We don't need lime because Mahonia likes the acid soil. About a half a cup. Yes, yeah, we really want to get that phosphorus in there, potassium in there. The nitrogen, normally, you wouldn't do much fertilizing in the fall. We don't want to stimulate new growth, but there's such a little amount of nitrogen in there, it doesn't really hurt. I'd rather have the phosphorus and potassium in there. Okay, yeah, let's see what this root ball looks like.
Wow, look at that root.
Yeah. Well, now that one has not bad here. But here, those roots are pretty thick, and I think just to make sure we have no problems with girdling roots, we'll just go ahead and cut those off. And the plant doesn't care. Okay. I think that's all right. Depth looks okay. Where's our front, Chris? You can rotate it. Okay. So we got our front facing out. Our depth is good. Oops. I just broke my microphone.
You didn't.
Well, it came off my clip. It's just too much technology.
Yeah, this is
okay.
Aha.
Aha. Perfect. Okay. Trying to be more careful. Okay. So we've got our mix of native soil and the pine bark fines. Trying to create a transition layer for the plant to go from that 100% pine bark root ball out to the native soil, which looks like this. So it's not bad, but still it's pretty heavy clay. And we want to try and encourage the plant to get out from the root ball itself. I really hope not sweat this morning. Dang it.
The root ball's still a little visible.
Yep.
You make it look so easy.
Well, that's just experience and practice. Yeah, I slept in that yesterday. That was an hour in digging three holes yesterday.
Well, you did it pretty fast in an hour.
So we still see the top of the root ball. We got the soil up to the edge of the root ball. I'm pretty happy with that. What do you think?
Beautiful.
Whew. Wow. Pardon?
What kind of light?
So it's sun to part shade. So here it's going to get a little, it'd have both. Mm-hmm. So it should do okay. Yes. Okay. Any questions about this? So I'm going to make sure that the depth is right. The width is right, and there's no soil on top of the root ball. Mix in a little pine fines to loosen the soil up, and after that, you're pretty much good to go.
And you don't put any mulch on the root ball?
Ideally not. So what I'll do is I'll pull the mulch back over. Around. You know, if you get a little bit on the root ball, it's not the end of the world. What we want to avoid is having it, you know, 3 and 4 inches deep on top of the root ball where the plant can't breathe. So, something like that.
Now, will you water it now?
Yes. Yes. After everything is said and done, I've got all my mess cleaned up. Then I'll come back in and water it in real well, and we should be in good shape. That'll be Chris's job. show water while I clean up my clods. Okay. Questions? We're good? Okay. Thank you very much.